I know. I'm an idiot. There, I said it. In my last video, the premiere song of Beheaded, I was talking to you guys about the contest, the vocal contest. And then I explained to you guys what you were able to win. And I was talking about 3 shirts and 3 albums. Yeah. A lot of people noticed and a lot of people commented on it. And maybe that was just a little part of Baldrick which I couldn't suppress. Anyway, if you have any other vocal than just a death metal vocal, I put in the description that it had to match Frank, his vocals. It doesn't. Frank also commented on someone who said, I can only do black metal vocals. Do your kind of vocals with the lyrics on the song. Just play the song on YouTube and sing along with it. Doesn't necessarily have to be growling. Just do your kind of vocals on the song, play the song, sing along with it, and we'll just pick the best one. So, if you win, you'll win 3 shirts and 3 albums. Ha! I got it right this time. So a little while ago I went to the Houten Death Fest, of which I did a video before I went there. You can click right there if you want to go and check it out. All in all, it was a cool party. I met a lot of cool people, but I wasn't as impressed as I was last year. And this is just my opinion, this is just what I think. Last year Beheaded was headlining and Carnal Decay played, Fractured Insanity, Godless Truth, Basement Torture, Killings, and that edition of Houten Death Fest, which was my first edition, it was more diverse than this year. This year it mostly consisted out of brutal or either slam death metal, and this year it looked a little bit as if it was a party for more younger people. Not that that bothers me, but I noticed it. There were more younger people, and it was a party for people that like to go into a circle waving their hands in the air, just like Indians did around a bonfire. You know, it wasn't really my thing. And throughout the day, I actually got more bored with the sound that was coming, and I was like, no, you know, no. And there's one thing, and that's not something I just noticed on the Houten Death Fest, but I noticed it on Neurotic Death Fest and other concerts and festivals I've been to recently. People who find it necessary to imitate Frank Mullen of Suffocation. And with that I mean the thing he does when there's a blast beat and he goes like this with his hands. You know, if Suffocation is playing and you want to make a fool out of him, because that is a little bit as it comes over to me, you know. He's standing there doing his thing and everybody goes like, yeah, I personally wouldn't imitate that, but if they're playing and you feel the need to go and do that, go right ahead. But I was at Neurotic Death Fest, Pewter Pa was playing, and there were a couple of people waving their hands in the air. I was like, that is just something I noticed, that is just something I think. If you think that's cool to do, be my guest. As always, do whatever you want, I just tell you guys what I think. That's it. So like I said, this year I wasn't really impressed. It was a little bit too boring for me. The sound was too boring. I like more diversity in death metal. That is why I like the Neurotic Death Fest. You can go from a slam death metal band to Hour of Penance to old school Morgoth playing big ones as Cannibal Corpse. There's always a lot of difference on Neurotic Death Fest. Even Carnifex played there. So, you know, diverse. You can pick something. And on the Houten Death Fest this year, I was like, no. However, it wasn't all bad, of course. I don't want to make it too negative. There were a few bands which did a really, really good job. And the first one is Amagortis. I was really looking forward to see these guys. And although these guys also play a slam death metal, they do have their own sound, you know. To me it didn't sound like the rest. Like other bands on the Houten Death Fest all sounded a little bit the same. Amagortis jumped out of there. And not because I made a video for these guys. I already thought that their sound on CD does not sound the same as all other slam death metal. So they did a really, really good job, and it was really cool to meet those guys. We didn't talk very long because it was a little bit chaotic, but I will see him again and we'll just talk a little bit longer then. The second band I really liked was Dictated, and these guys are from Holland, the Netherlands, whatever you want. They also have slam parts in their music, but not on the annoying side, you know? I mean, some of those slam death metal bands push so many slam in their music, you go like, give us a blast beat, you know? And in Dictated, and I'll just show you guys a picture, or you'll see some video footage. I think I recorded every band, so I'll just put every band on the end of this video. You'll see that there are two women actually in Dictated. So yeah, I really like to see bands which have a girl all of a sudden in the band, you know? I think more women should pick up a guitar or whatever, pick up a microphone and get into metal. I mean, metal is for everybody, and I think it's cool to see that women are getting involved in a band. So that's really cool. And I think that they also did an amazing job. It's a good band. There was also a guy outside of the Houten Death Fest who had their logo tattooed on their arm. And I was like, isn't that a little bit early? I mean, I got a new tattoo. A couple of you guys already noticed. I got a Venom tattoo. But Venom has been around since the Stone Age. And not that Dictator will not, but I was like, no, they're not as old as a band such as Venom. And to take their, well, yeah, wasn't really my idea of a good tattoo. Anyway, it was a cool guy for the rest, but that idea was, no. Then the next band, Unbreakable Hatred, was really fucking awesome. I met them backstage, and it was just three guys on stage, and I was like, okay, you know, I heard the album is really fucking good. And I saw them on stage, and I was like, okay, let's see what they can do live. And they did it. I was standing there next to, I believe, RJ of Temple, well, whoever. I was standing next to somebody and we were both watching Unbreakable Hatred like, holy fucking shit, you know, such a brutality. They actually didn't really fit on the bill of this Houten Death Fest, you know. The most bands were like, and Unbreakable Hatred was like, you know, we make death metal and we're gonna show you we make death metal. So they just kept on going. Really fucking awesome. If you have the chance to go and see them, go do that. And then for me personally, the best band of the entire night, which really did not fit on this bill, and not because they didn't make that kind of music, they were not like the other guys. They, you know, a little bit more mature in my opinion. And I read a review from some guy on the internet who said that Khaoz, which I'm talking about, was the worst band of the entire night. There is where I think Khaoz was the best band of the night. I mean, Jose was standing next to me, Jose was with me, and after four or five bands, Jose went to go sit in the car because she didn't, you know, she didn't like it anymore. To me, Khaoz was the best band of the night, and even Jose liked their performance a whole lot. Really cool guys. I met them outside, and the singer and everybody, I met them. Really cool guys and a really good performance. And I like Khaoz a lot, and just like I said, that review was like, they're the worst band. Yeah, you know, if you, just like I said, if you like to run around in a circle with your hands in the air on that kind of shit, you know, just be my guest. But I think Khaoz fucking ruled, and they were the best band of the Houten Death Fest. And they played the second band, and some people said, like, it's a shame that they play second because not a whole lot of people are moving. Well, the room was pretty filled, but people were just standing there like, not slam enough, you know, not slow enough. I think it ruled. And I'm just gonna show you guys all the footage that I got of the Houten Death Fest. And I hope you guys like it. And I hope you guys liked my review. So, enjoy the footage. And I hope to see Khaoz again, and Dictated, and Amagortis, and Unbreakable Hatred. And if I don't see the rest, I won't sleep a day or a night less about it. So, see you guys next video. Take care.